Snipe Squad, what it going on, boy? I'm talking about on. Back again, it is your boy Snapper Jones coming back with another video. I know it's been a while since my last upload, man. It's killing me as well. But just know, man, your boy is cooking up some fire videos, and I promise you, I got bangers on the way, and that's on dog. But if you are new to this channel, man, if this is your first time watching the video, go through the library. I got nothing but bangers, you know what I'm saying? Also, make sure you hit that subscribe button. We grinding, trying to hit 10K before the end of the year. Hit that like button, hit the notification bell so we can get this video as far as we possibly can. So y'all know me, man. All of these Jordans that's dropping, there's been so many J's that's been dropping. It's been almost crazy to keep up. This particular pair, y'all know what it is. Y'all seen it in the thumbnail. These are the Jordan 5 Wings. Now, me personally, I'm not really too big a fan of sneakers that got a lot of animation on them, all the colors, all of the extra stuff going into it. That's usually not my thing, you know what I'm saying? I don't really get down like that. But this particular pair, after I seen it hand, I'm like, y'all gotta bring this back to the channel. This particular pair I'm bringing to the channel aren't my personal pair. I wanna give a huge shout out to my boy Retro Rico. He was able to let me use these to go ahead and give y'all a detailed review. So if y'all need any pairs, if y'all missed out on something, before release date, if you're trying to get like that pre-order or whatever y'all trying to look for, if y'all need pairs, hit on my guy Retro Rico. I will link his IG down below in the description. Good dude, my homie. I know him personally. Trust me, you in good hands. Hit my man's up. He can probably help you out. So he had these pairs, and when I pulled up on them, I checked them out, and I was like, yo, man, these are fire. I'm not even gonna lie, they flames. And from the initial pictures, I didn't like them at all, so I was kind of surprised, and I think a lot of y'all gonna be surprised too once you're able to see these up close and in person. Y'all know how we rocking, man. It's the same thing on dog, you know what I'm saying? Your boy Snapper Jones coming with the heat as much as I possibly can. Yay! Coming off with the all-white box, it kind of reminds me of an OVO box, low-key. I don't know. Anytime I see something with Jordan brand and I see white and gold, black and gold, I automatically get an OVO feel to it. But obviously, it's not no damn OVO. These are a size 11.5, by the way, so I can fit these, you know what I'm saying? Rico, if you probably weren't watching this video, I'll probably run up on a plug, you know what I'm saying, on dog. As soon as you open up the box, you get this letter from Jordan Brand. It says, wings, everyone can fly. And yeah, you get a small little message on the back. I'm not really sure if I'm gonna read throughout this whole thing because I know it's not what y'all came here for. But I do wanna say that on the back, it has the Jordan Brand logo and it has Little Black Pearl, the business of art. Check that out, right? Go ahead and focus, go ahead and focus. Okay, cool, so y'all see that. Right there, the Jordan Brand and Little Black Pearl. The reason why I want to bring up the Little Black Pearl is because that is basically the inspiration that this shoe is created off of. The Little Black Pearl is basically a workshop out in Illinois, Chicago, Illinois, that basically put all of the drawings on this shoe. These are actual sketches that people from that workshop actually created, and Jordan Brand was actually able to, you know, collab and get this shoe out. So it's kind of dope that he was able to actually do that. Off the tops, man, let's see what we got. Now, I've seen these briefly, but man, in the studio with these lights, bro, I'm not gonna hold you, man. These, they fire, bro. They extra, extra fire. Like I said, I'm not really too big on all the colors and all the animations, but once you feel the leather, first of all, the leather quality on this shoe is crazy. I'm not even gonna hold you. Just feel like if anybody hoop, right? Anybody hoop, comment down. Damn. If anybody in here hoop, bro, you know this feeling. This leather. If you hoop, you know you hoop with the Evolution ball, the Wilson Evolution ball. And it's like, you can't really hoop with it that well when you first buy it because it get all, as soon as it gets sweaty, it's slippery. But once it get that wear and tear, it's like the softest, smoothest leather you will ever feel. I know it's like a random comparison to a basketball, but if you hoop, trust me, you know exactly what I mean. This leather is amazing. It's detailed. No, it's not like a tumble that you'll get on a Jordan 1. It's just soft, it's smooth, it's buttery, and it's throughout the entire shoe. Now, as I told you guys, the sketches that's on this shoe were designed by the people that were at the Little Black Pearl Workshop, which is an art studio in Chicago, Illinois. So you see a lot of illustrations all over the entire shoe, whether it be sketches or even quotes, man. Like, it's all types of stuff going out the entire sneaker. One thing I can honestly say is Jordan Brand always do some conscious effort about collabing, not even with just big brands like Supreme or PSNY's. It's more like you see them collab with art institutes, or even when they collab with Dornbecker Foundation. You know what I'm saying? It's always something special with Jordan Brand, and that's something that I take to the fullest. It's always a dope effect that they do. Starting off at the base of the shoe, of course you got the translucent sole with your black Jumpman at the top, man, and of course you get the Jordan across the middle of the sole. Moving up to the midsole, you get the all-white midsole, and you get those teal blue shark teeth that is super, super dope. The shark teeth on Jordan 5, for some reason, always add that extra flair to the midsole area. Now it's time for the uppers, right? The uppers are so crazy. From the colorways, to the material, to the sketching, to even the messages that you get from actually reading the shoe. If y'all ever seen like Jordan's lasers, like the laser 20s or like the laser Jordan 1s, it's a lot of hidden messages or a lot of hidden pictures inside the lasers, if y'all never knew that. This kind of reminds me of that in a sense, because even if you look like right here on the toe box, you'll see some stuff, you see some quotes. One says, start a revolution, change the world. Another one says, be a visionary. And I see another one that says, the law of attraction increases positivity. So it's a lot of hidden messages on this shoe that's super dope. I love whenever a sneaker get like a personal, in-depth type of relationship with the sneaker, and I honestly felt like they did with this Jordan 5 wing for sure. Now between me and y'all, man, y'all know your boy Shopper Jones. I ain't really like the biggest art, what you call it, connoisseur of all time, you feel me? So I don't really want to get too far into what's being drawn, because between me and you, bro, I really don't know. What I can say for sure by looking at the shoe is, it's not just murals and nothing like that. I can see like children's paintings, like on this toe box, how you see like a little girl stick figure. Like that's obviously a kid's drawing. But then on the other side, if you look right here on the uppers, you see like the Jordan logo with a sun around it, and you see like the legs of a Jumpman. Or you look here on the back heel tab, you see some more introspective type artwork. That honestly just shows that the ranges of the people who drew this was like up and down. It wasn't like a set person who just decided to make this shoe or just crafted it. It looked like it was like random paintings or random drawings from that specific workshop that was put on this shoe. Another dope thing that I liked about this shoe is the caging that's on the actual Jordan 5. Y'all know usually the caging looks like a netting type material. This particular Jordan 5 is using a wing type material. It looks just like a wing design on the caging of the Jordan 5. In my opinion, or to my knowledge, that's like the only time a Jordan 5 has ever switched it up from like the regular looking knitting. Whether they change the color is one thing, but this is a whole nother design on the knitting by itself. I've never seen that before. Moving up to the tongue, of course you get that iconic 3M tongue that's literally probably on every Jordan 5. Don't quote me on that, cause I'm probably wrong. But most likely you're gonna get a 3M tongue on a Jordan 5. You got that black sock liner. And last but not least, you get the wings on your laces. Hint, hint, you know what I'm saying, the Jordan 5 wing for everybody who's a little slow out there. On the left sneaker, you get your two alternate laces, which is the black lace, and then you get the teal lace. So if you one of them dudes that like to switch up the laces, you know what I'm saying, they give you two different options, two different ways for you to lace and style these joints. Me personally, I've never really been big on switching up the laces, even when they give me extra pairs of my Jordan 1s. The pair that's usually in be the pairs that I usually keep. I know a lot of you guys like to switch it up, and there's nothing wrong with that. It's basically just preference, but they give you two different options whenever you copping the Jordan 5 wing. I don't really think this sneaker was sought after. It's a lot of people in the sneaker community on YouTube, and honestly, I haven't really seen too many reviews of this shoe. Usually when a sneaker drops, you see it's flooded down everybody's timeline with nothing but reviews on the newest release. This particular Jordan brand sneaker was not. But now it's time to be honest, right? Let's be honest. Will I ever rock these? Like, if I own them, would I ever rock them? The answer would be absolutely no. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. Space Jam 11s I haven't worn yet, you know what I'm saying? Shadow 1s I haven't worn yet. So I know personally, this pair of shoes, like, it would take me forever to actually rock these. But what I can say, if you're a collector, and you enjoy Jordan brand and you wanna collect something that was big to the contribution of Jordan brand, this is a sneaker that you need in your collection. I can honestly say that. Oh damn, oh my goodness. How the hell, I almost forgot. The dopest part about this sneaker is it glows in the dark. I don't know how the hell I almost forgot to tell y'all that this shoe glows in the dark. So anytime a shoe glows in the dark, the value of it just goes up dramatically. I don't know why, but it just is what it is. This whole cage, the side cage glows up in the dark. I believe that this lace holder glows up in the dark. That is a great touch. But that is pretty much it for the Jordan 5. Let me know what y'all think. If you haven't already followed me on Instagram or Twitter, it is down below in your left-hand corner. Make sure you go ahead and do that. Once again, subscribe to the channel for great content, man. Y'all know it's coming. This weekend is about to be crazy. I got a lot of great content coming. Also, guys, use my Rejuvenator code. It is down below in the description. Anything you get off Rejuvenator's website will be 10% off if you just use the promo code SNIPERJONES. If you do that and you send me a tweet, or if you DM me on Instagram, Instagram, Twitter, and you show me that you use my promo code, I will shout you out in my next video. I will show you love for showing me love. SneakerCon Atlanta is coming soon. Yes, I will be there. I know a lot of people have been reaching out, asking me, will I be there? Of course, I live in Atlanta. I will be there both days, Saturday and Sunday. I'm not positively sure on the dates, but I will be at SneakerCon Atlanta. So if you want to link up, if you want to chill, kick it, come through, make sure y'all stop by. I will be in that thing on dog. Until next time, man, it is your boy Snapper Jones, and I will catch up with y'all. Gang, gang.